Take one. My first impression, I mean, it would either be Selena Quintanilla, the singer I was named after, or Britney Spears. To me, they represented, like the idol, like the woman, you know. Britney was younger, so she was like someone I kind of looked up to, and Selena had passed, so I felt like she was almost an icon to me, so they represented what they believed in then very well. 2012 it was definitely more of my like transition year, I guess. Last year was completely about music and touring everywhere I could possibly tour, and it kind of shifted this year to just taking a break from music. And I got to do my first movie, which was Spring Breakers, and it was more of like an indie role, and it was completely different for me. Harmony Korine, which is the director, has such a specific vision, and he really brings it to life in so many fun ways. All of it was really real. I mean, we were in real situations, in real motels, with real Spring Breakers. Working with James Franco was really incredible, because he was extremely nice, but you could see how driven he is, and he played a character he's never played before. It was so interesting to see him get into character. The advice that my mom gave me in the beginning, and even still to this day, is like, if I'm not having fun, if I'm really not enjoying it anymore, she doesn't want me to do it. I mean, the moment I was 7 and started, that was what she always told me, and she let me dress myself for auditions and do my own hair and stuff, and she just wanted me to have fun with it as if it was like a play every day. So whenever I kind of get lost in all of like the stuff that kind of gets annoying of what I do, I always have to remind myself that when I'm on set and when I'm on stage and I'm with my fans, it's extremely rewarding and it's still a lot of fun.